Alright, hello everyone. This is Tom Martell with Channel Fireball, bringing you a standard league featuring Owen Turtenwald's almost exact 75 from the top 8 that actually, as I'm recording this, is going on right now. So pretty excited to bring you this. This deck's a lot of fun to play. And we'll be off. All this hand's an easy keep. We have an early roadblock. We have some ways to set things up. I think it's quite good. So on turn one, I think I'm going to lead Vessel. I don't really care about having this Gnarlwood Dryad in play right away. It's not as important. Just getting our engine going, finding some land to hit play, getting some good sweet Philip our Graveyard with sweet stuff with these Grapple with the Pasts. Vessel is definitely the correct turn one play in this spot. Let's see what he is up to over here. Swamp. Alright, so probably either Black Green Delirium or Black White Control. Those are the two most likely decks that that lead with the Swamp. Okay. Use Grasp of Darkness mana up. Found an Embercle, but I'm going to take this forest, I think, so we can reveal and play an untapped game trail. So you can always pick the Embercle back up later with the... I guess either way, you can pick up the thing with... I might want untapped land this turn. I can definitely see that being wrong. So many Kozilek returns. The nice thing about putting Embercle in the graveyard now is if he transgresses us, he can't take it. So I actually think that's definitely correct. We'll leave the Embercle sitting in the graveyard until we finally want to cast it. And then we'll just go ahead and grapple it back. Matter Reshaper. Okay, so he's playing some kind of... Emerge deck, most likely. Okay, good. We got a little Valium Pilgrim's Eye here. We do have Delirium turned on now, which is nice. Okay, so one downside we have currently, I mean, this might be something like Bundle Buck Eldrazi. I haven't seen all the decks in the PT yet. I'll be honest, I haven't looked at I didn't want to spoil my chance to be surprised. Ooh, I don't like this attack from him. I get to hit Liliana now. So he's trading 3 loyalty on Liliana for 3 damage, which seems like a bad trade to me. Oh, hello, Embercle. You cost 7 mana right now. In our graveyard. So we just get another Pilgrim's Eye back here. Could save this Grapple though just to get back an Embercle. I think I might just do that at this point. I'm a little bit torn here. I think I'm just going to say go. Yeah. What's it going to be here? So yeah, so I guess this card actually might have been, ooh, yep, gross. Let him declare attackers, and then we'll go ahead and just cast his Kozilek's Return. is 2-1. That's annoying. So I actually don't get to kill Liliana here. Ruins of Orin Reef. Okay. I want to put a Close Patrol in my graveyard so I can blink it back. I think I'm going to grapple into turn here, though. Oh, right, we just put 2 damage on a thing. That was stupid. Alright. Remembering how to play magic here, slowly but steadily. That turn was not... It got eliminated, not played optimally. Since I threw in my Norwood Dryad for no reason. I mean, not for no reason. I saved 3 damage, but I don't think it was worth it. So now with the Fade, Transgress the Mind here, pretty important that he doesn't have that right now. Since we cash in that grapple. Okay, definitely on some kind of black green Eldrazi. Could also just be mono black and playing this for another colorless land, but. Which would make sense. Having a black colorless dual land is really important. Uh-oh, something big. Yep. Okay. Ouch. I go to 3 here. Okay. Yeah, I will go ahead and close this return this guy. And play this giant Duder, which will hopefully be enough. I really need to make him Blighted Fen this turn, so he can't just Blighted Fen my Embercoil. So I guess actually, if I was going to do that, I probably shouldn't have gotten rid of my Kozak's Return there, maybe. Okay. Wow, that's gross. I didn't draw land, so I can't. Yeah, I'm gonna have to let him Blighted Fen me. So I'm probably gonna play Bear of Silence plus Liliana on it, transgress himself. That doesn't really work either, though. If he transgresses himself. For 2. Man, I'm at 3 life. One, two, how much mana do I have? He has 7. So I can play out his whole hand. And then I can transgress one, the Matter Reshaper, play the Liliana. So I cast Bear of Silence, I plus Lily on it, I play the second Lily, I minus that Lily and whiff, and then I transgress the Matter Reshaper. Then on his turn, he'll just fend my Emrakul, and I'll play a second Emrakul. That seems pretty strong. Do I need to play the second Liliana? Yeah, I need to play the second Liliana, so I need to make sure I don't... 1, I use all my black mana here, so okay, so on. Okay, so Bear comes in. Kill Bear. Play Liliana. Minus Liliana. Transgress oneself. And pass the turn. Okay, so he has no cards in hand. He has to spend his turn edicting me and just plusing this Liliana. At which point, then I get to play a second Emrakul and minus his Liliana to kill it. So I'm in pretty good shape here. He's gonna be at 18. He conceded. Well, he definitely didn't need to concede there. He wasn't completely dead. But I'll take it. Alright, so it's like white black Eldrazi. I'm guessing you want this against decks that have transgress. Probably to do that, and this. Those probably don't. What's my best plan with Liliana? I just don't want these. Interesting spot here. So I'm not sure like exactly. I want the Narwhal Dryads. Gather Pack's never been exciting for me. Maybe I just kind of gather the pack. I know it's like an enabler. Chandra. One Chandra seems useful. It also has like Barrows of Silence and things. So he can definitely get beatdown draws where he goes like Bearer into Matter Shaper. So I think I want all the Kozilek's returns. I like having the one Chandra. I could see cutting this and leaving in the Gather Pack. That could just be awful. But in the end, I'm sort of like just shaving numbers here. So I'm gonna make that shave. I don't think I need Fire Impulse though. It's not that fast. I think this should be fine. Okay, hand's good. Hopefully it doesn't come out too fast over there. Sounds, I assume. Oh, okay, sure. Goodbye, probably Ishkana. Yep. Just gonna use Vessel here. Try to get my Gather the Pack powered up. I'll be honest, I've never hit two creatures with this thing, even if I've had Spell Mastery turned on. So I would not mind doing that for the first time here. What do we find? Okay, we find a bunch of lands and a deep feed. Well, we need a deep end. I'm just gonna take this mountain. We want to find some Nissa's Pilgrimages. That card is great. Oh shoot, I shouldn't have played the land. That was really bad. If I gather the pack and I find a the Dryad, I want to be able to play it. think I'm actually going to just Kozuck's return his guy. And that way, yeah, the pack will be turned. Yeah, I'm just going to say go here. Maybe greedy. I won't gather the pack to get me spell mastery. Even if it probably doesn't matter. So I'm going to take three and then end of turn I'm going to play Kozuck's return. This line could be really bad. Yay, we got the 2-for-1. Oh, he gets cards back, so not really. But at least we got, this is a big tempo play now. Let's see what he finds. Hedron Crawler into the play, and a transgress into his hand, okay. Sure, he's a transgress of the mind. That makes my gather the pack a lot worse. So if I cast Gather, yeah, I'm still just going to cast to Gather the Pack. Even though he gets to take, I found one thing, that's fine. Since Trendress already had two targets, if I find like an Emrakul or something, it means he can't take my other Eldrazi. So, trade-offs there. I think not casting is just so tempo negative. I mean, I want to use my mana there, so if I draw something like a Chandra, I can play it this turn. I'm guessing he takes a Deep Fiend here, actually. I don't think he cares much about Retrogriff. Although, it is only 7 mana to hard cast, so I'm only one. No, I'm 2 turns away. Yeah, that makes sense. I agree with that play. But he's missing a 5th land over there, which is important. Because it's keeping him off of... As he knows my own lands, doesn't really matter what I do here. It's keeping him off of Reality Smasher, which is big. So if he misses a land drop again here, he can't start smashing us before we get to play our Deep Fiend, the first one, which is nice. Okay, goodbye Deep Fiend. It was a cute idea while it lasted. We've got 8 mana here, so we can play this Griff. Could play Chandra and plus it, but I'm going to play the Griff instead. The reason for that is, maybe I shouldn't, because I forgot about this Kozuck's return. But I don't want to play Chandra and then he just plays Rally Smasher. Oh, I can just take out his Hedron Crawler. So I'm actually just going to do that. I probably should have actually played Flame Crawler and just minused it. Honestly, that might have been best. Ooh, okay, I was going to draw. Not sure what the right play was that turn. We had a lot of good options. Oh no, we just lost. Okay, well, the downside of the option we went for is we just lost our second red source because we flashed back our... Anyway, the card's devoid anyway, so we only had one red. So we couldn't play Chandra. So we accidentally made the right play. We had the best intentions. Only the best intentions. Hello, Ishkana. You were a nice dressed up. And with our opponent still stuck on 3 mana, you know, 2 mana away from playing anything like Reality Smasher business, nowhere near playing any, like, you know, big guys. I think this one's going to get away from him right now. Yep. All right. On the board.